How do polyglots learn languages? How are some people able to speak so many languages? What is their secret? I know that many people are asking themselves these questions, and if you're among them, I have excellent news for you. You're about to find out the number one tip of 6 extremely successful polyglots who agreed to join me for this video. When I started learning languages many years ago, I was eager to know how some people managed to learn 2, 3, 5, 10, and even 20 languages. Today I'm lucky enough to speak 8 languages and to know a lot of successful polyglots. Therefore, I want to help you benefit from their and my experience to make progress faster. Let's start with Benny Lewis, a very famous polyglot from Ireland. Benny is the creator of the Fluent in 3 Months blog. He published a best-selling book and speaks 11 languages. So Benny, what is your best tip for learning a language?
Hey Luca, thanks so much for having me. So my number one tip for learning languages is always that you have to speak from day one. And what I mean by this is something that a lot of us tend to do, especially if we have tendencies for perfectionism, is to put off speaking our target language and thinking that if I prepare enough, then someday later on, maybe 6 months from now, maybe 2 years from now, I'll be ready to speak the language. And this day never really comes, because no matter how much you prepare, no matter how much you study, there's always going to be more that you have to do. So I've talked to a lot of people about this, and that feeling of I'm ready now doesn't really hit us. So the best way around this is just to decide that maybe day one has to be the day that you're ready, and you have to embrace sounding like a caveman a little bit and making mistakes. And that's been a huge part of the success I've personally had with languages, is to start speaking as soon as possible and to keep that momentum up and to improve as I speak, instead of making it about preparing for the long term. So speak from day one, and good luck with that.
Great, that's a very useful tip. Thank you, Benny. Now let's travel to Italy to meet another extremely successful polyglot, Luca Lampariello. Luca speaks 14 languages at a very high level. He's a language coach and successful language learner whose passion is very contagious. So, Luca, what's your number one tip for learning a language?
Hi, Luca. And first of all, thanks a bunch for inviting me. My number one tip to learn a language, any language, is to understand why you're learning it. After 30 years of learning languages, I've understood that the most important ingredient for language learning success is to establish an emotional connection with your target language. It's not trying to say that if you understand your why, you will figure out the how. But of course, establishing an emotional connection is great in theory, but it might turn out to be a wee bit more difficult to do in practice. So here's a simple and powerful exercise you can start with. Take a piece of paper and a pencil or a pen and think about a person you're going to speak to in your target language. Think about the circumstances where this is going to happen. What are you guys going to talk about? Where? Why? Connect all that and create a story through the power of your mind. Einstein used to say that imagination is more important than knowledge. Imagination is the language of the soul. Pay attention to your imagination and you will discover all you need to be fulfilled. With Einstein's wise words in mind, jot down a vivid, compelling, and realistic story of you living through, in, and with your target language. Keep that written story next to you every time you learn as a powerful reminder. Whenever the road towards fluency becomes bumpy, whenever you get tired, discouraged, you will reach your destination if you know where you're going and why you're going there.
Very inspiring and well said, Luca. Thanks a lot. Now let me welcome another famous polyglot who has 8 languages under his belt. Ollie Richards. Ollie is the creator of Story Learning, where he makes language learning books and courses to help people learn languages with stories. So welcome, Ollie. Can you share with our viewers your best tip for learning a language?
Hey, Luca, thank you so much for having me. Now, the number one tip that I'd like to give people is to spend longer selecting the perfect language learning material for you. Because in my mind, the secret to learning languages is understanding how you learn best and then doubling down on that. Too often, people just take the first book or app or course that they find and just expect it to work. But really experimenting and taking the time to look through different material and find out what works for you will really pay dividends in the long run. So let me give you an example. Here are the three books in Spanish that you might choose to learn, use to learn Spanish. You've got a book of poetry in Spanish, which is 20 Poemas de Amor by Pablo Neruda. And this is all in Spanish and it's poetry, but they're quite short, like single pages. So they, you know, they're accessible. And that's a certain type of learning. You might like this if you love immersion in the real thing. This is a book of parallel text, that's short stories in kind of real Spanish with the Spanish on one side and the English on the other. This might be for you if you like to always be translating, for example, from the target language into English. And then this is my book, and it's a book of short stories, but it's all in Spanish, but it's actually graded so it's not too hard for you, so you can actually enjoy it. That's again a different kind of dynamic. So my challenge to you is to really think about what works for you. And if you don't find yourself really gelling with a certain kind of material, try more stuff until you really land on that thing that works for you and excites you.
So true. Cheers, Oli. Now, let's go to Germany to meet Gabriel Gellmann. Gabriel is the co-founder of Spring Languages and the creator of Sprachelt, one of the most visited German blogs about languages. Gabriel speaks six languages and has a lot to share about the most effective ways to learn languages. By the way, Gabriel recently published a video featuring myself and some other polyglots who gave their number one tip on how to learn Spanish. Click on the screen or on the link below to check it out. So, Gabriel, what is your number one tip to learn languages?
Thank you, Luca, for inviting me to this video. My number one tip for learning any language is learning it in chunks. Chunks are word combinations natives use all the time while speaking. Just listening to the chunks natives say and use the same chunks in the foreign language makes it much easier to get fluent fast. Let's have a look at a few examples of chunks in English. How is it going? Just as important, my favorite thing in the world. Merry Christmas. What do you think? By the way. And in German. Wie geht's? Ich habe keine Lust. Auf keinen Fall. And in Spanish. ¿Qué tal? Mucho gusto. Me gusta. Most people learn a language by combining words and grammar into sentences. Doing this takes ages. You have to think about grammar rules, remember words, and you translate in your head. Instead of this painful process, why not skip that step of putting vocabulary and grammar together and just say directly the same stuff natives say all the time? How does that work? First, listen to what natives say. Listen a lot. I'm sure I'm not the only guest here that says that. But the next step is just as important. Don't just try to understand what they say, but also focus on the exact word combinations natives use. Everything you hear where you think, ah, so that's how a native speaker would say it. I was always using a clumsy translation from my mother tongue, but I didn't know that that's the natural way of saying it. Once you've heard such a chunk, memorize it and say it exactly the same way when speaking that foreign language. The result? You'll know 100% sure that what you're saying is correct, and you'll sound natural. You can still learn some grammar, but these chunks are what will help you bypass grammar while speaking and make you sound like a native speaker. So in short, here's my advice. Listen as much as possible to native speakers. That way you can discover lots of chunks and then start using them yourself.
Thank you, Gabriel. That's great advice. Let's remain in Germany to meet Elisa Polese, an Italian polyglot who has studied 25 languages and teaches 13 of them. Elisa absolutely loves languages, and her mission is to help people from all around the world speak their target language from day one and tap into their full potential. Hi, Elisa. So what's your number one tip for learning languages?
Hi, Luca. Thanks for having me. I've coached hundreds of people. And I can tell you that the main reason why people don't achieve their language goal is that they give up too soon. A quote I love states, "If you are fed up of starting over, stop giving up. Learn every single day, even just for 1 minute, and you will get closer to your goal day by day. It's better if you choose a sustainable amount of time than choosing to study many hours a day, not being able to keep it up, feeling frustrated and giving up."
Thank you for your great insights, Elisa. And now let's hear from Steve Kaufman, a former Canadian diplomat and successful polyglot who speaks more than 20 languages. Steve co-founded the company Link and has inspired thousands of people and polyglots thanks to his videos about language learning. So happy to have you here, Steve. What's your number one tip about language learning?
Hi, Luca. Thank you for having me. What is my number one tip for language learning? Have fun with it. If there's one thing that all successful polyglots have in common, is that they enjoy language learning. They have fun learning languages. They find it interesting. They find ways to make it interesting. If they like going through flashcards, they do it. If they don't like going through flashcards, they don't. They make sure they listen to content that they find interesting. They listen to content where the voice is pleasing to them. They look up elements of grammar when they're curious, when they want to learn that particular point. They don't allow the teacher to dictate what they're going to learn. In other words, they have fun. And if you don't continue, if you feel an obligation to do something that you don't find interesting, find things about the language, ways in which you can engage with the language that are interesting to you, fun for you, and keep doing them. And if they are fun for you, you will continue doing them. So to me, the most important tip for language learning is to find ways to have fun. Because if you have fun, you will succeed. So with that, I wish everyone success in their language learning. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. That's a wise tip. And now it's my turn. If you're not new to this channel, you should already know me a little bit. My name is Luca Sadurni, I'm the co-founder of MozaLingua, and so far I've taught myself 6 foreign languages. I have to say that I agree with what my polyglot friends have said, but let me add another important dimension. I'm sure you already know this quote attributed to the author of the famous book The Little Prince. A goal without a plan is just a wish. In other words, if you want to make something happen, you need to plan how to do it. Here's a quick process you can use. First, establish your goal. For example, being able to get by during your next international trip. Second, decide how much time per day you can study. 10-15 minutes a day is enough if you study every day. 3. Schedule when you're going to study. The best time for me is right when I wake up. Of course, you can choose whatever time is best suitable for you. 4. Take action every day and stick to your plan. And finally, reap the benefits of your learning. That's all for today. Let's recap the great tips we got. Benny Lewis, speak from day one. Luca Lamparello, establish an emotional connection with your target language. Ollie Richards, choose the perfect learning material for you. Gabriel Gelman, learn language chunks from native speakers. Elisa Polese, don't give up too soon and study every day. Steve Kaufman, have fun while learning. And myself, Luca Sadurni, plan how to reach your language learning goals. Take care and happy learning.
If you learned something new from this video, give it a thumbs up. Then hit subscribe and turn on your notifications. Have a look around our channel for more hacks and tips. And if you're watching on another social media platform, like or follow our page. See you next time.